Hello, my name is ScoreH97 and today I'm going to be showing you how to start the MadDogs MD-82. First we want to start the battery in the APU, so click here to open up the overhead panel. Click here to turn the battery on. Just wait for the battery to turn on and then all the warnings to be listed. Okay, that's all of them. To turn the APU on, make sure APU air is turned off. APU right bus on. APU left bus on. Then moving down to the fuel panel, fuel tanks on the left and the right side to be turned on, and the start pump is turned on. And turn the air conditioning supply to auto. Now we should be pretty much ready to start start the APU. Just make sure that in the throttle quadrant that you have the left block here down and this one up, otherwise it won't start. Okay, now we can start the APU. All you do is turn the APU master to on or to start. Just have to wait a few seconds. See the APU start light's turned on here, and the APU rev dial is started to increase. Once it gets to about 80 or 90, I'm not sure what it is, it will turn on and you'll be able to have power. Just wait for that, it'll probably take about 20 seconds or so. And in the background you'll hear it starting up. When it gets to about here, it says the APU power is available, and you get a few warnings. That means the APU is fully started. So now we can prepare to start our engines. Okay, start the engines, bring the APU air to on. Start system A. Get the throttle quadrant up. Around about here, just put it down there, it's just easy. So you can see your N1 and 2 all everything down here. Okay, what you need to do is we're going to start the right engine, so make sure the HP bleed is set to auto. Flick down the starter cap and you can just click again and drag down. Just make sure the APU air is down to fully, so air is all the way down. Then the engine will start. N2 will get to about 10. Then you need to turn the HP bleed to off. And it will continue going up. When it gets to about 20, you need to, you need to pull this lever up to allow the fuel to go into the cylinders, and the engine will turn over and start. As you see now. Okay, now we can turn the starter off. Go down here, push this block down and that one up, and bring the bleed on the other side to auto. Now bring the left engine start cap down. Push the starter down to start. And it's the same as last engine. Reaches 10 and stops. Turn the HP bleed off. And the same when it gets to about 23, pull the fuel lever up so you can bring fuel into the cylinders. And the engine turns over. Now you can bring this lock down to normal, so it's down, and you can close the throttle quadrant. Now what we want to do is turn the starter off, put the cap back over. We can turn the engine start system off, and we can now turn the APU off. So turn the left and the right buses off, APU to off, and turn the master off as well. So the engine, so the APUs turns off. You'll get a pilot/stall heat warning. You need to go down to here and turn it to captain. So the pilot is on. You can turn the seatbelts on if you want, and the smoking signs, start pump can go off. I turn the anti-ice and everything else on. If you need it, as required. Okay, you can get rid of the overhead panel now. And now, what we need to do is you need to set markers on the EPR dial here. So, if you take off on full throttle, then your engines burn out and you have a flame out on one of the engines. So, try set the marker to around about 210, which is the maximum I've probably got mine up to. And it just marks so you don't over throttle your engines and have the engine flame out, because if one of the engines flames out, then you won't be able to start it back up again. Okay, we've done that. We need to set trim, which is here. Just get this trim thing here into the green area there, so we'll get a sound when it's going down. And be patient, it does take a bit of time for the trim to actually trim itself into the right position. And set the flaps to 15, as it's the takeoff flaps. And you'll see down here that the flaps are going down, and this light will turn on for takeoff. It tells you in the right position for takeoff. And now you're pretty much ready to depart. If you want to set autopilot, you can. So, thanks for watching. I hope this helped you.